Monday, Dunstan Patriots. My name's Leanna Hoon, and I'm filming right in my backyard. That's why there's dogs barking. I'm going to be guiding you through this week's PTV episode. Now, let's kick it off on a good start and go on to the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Make a big noise playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place. Singing,
We will rock you. We will rock you.
Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street. Gonna take on the world someday. You got blood on your face, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
We will rock you.
Sing it!
We will rock you.
Buddy, you're an old man, poor man, pleading with your eyes. Gonna make you zombie someday. You got mud on your face, big disgrace. Somebody better put your bag into your place.
Decorating for Halloween. I'm super excited for this because this is like my favorite holiday. So I am really excited for this.
And then down here we have ghosts, fencing, graveyards and bones and stuff. Bunch of lights. And then in the tree we have a mummy. And then we have an electric fence. Spiderweb. Rest in pieces. So, have a good week, Dunstan Patriots. See you next week.
You're that one girl in gymnastics who thinks she's better than literally everyone else.
I can
see
that.
POV, that one girl who wears jeans to dance class.
Splits!
POV, that one weirdo at the park who's always watching.
Now, Miss Gertz is going to be continuing our teacher story time with one of her favorites. Let's go see what it is.
Hi, everybody. My name is Mrs. Gertz, and I am one of the learning specialists here at Dunstan. I co-teach 7th grade language arts with Miss Allen. I also co-teach eighth grade language arts with Miss Rittenhouse, and then I teach an intervention study skills class called PACE. So excited that you guys are all here. And one of the things that I want to share with you is one of my favorite stories called Alexander and the Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Very Bad Day. It is a great book with a wonderful message that says, even though we have bad days, they can happen anywhere. So I hope you enjoy it. Alexander and the Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Very Bad Day by Judith Voist. I went to sleep with gum in my mouth, and now there's gum in my hair. And when I got out of bed this morning, I tripped on the skateboard, and by mistake, I dropped my sweater in the sink while the water was running, and I could tell it was going to be a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. At breakfast, Anthony found a Corvette Stingray car in kit in his breakfast cereal box, and Nick found a junior undercover agent code ring in his breakfast cereal box. But in my breakfast cereal box, all I found was breakfast cereal. I think I'll move to Australia. In the carpool, Miss Gibbons let Becky have the seat by the window. Audrey and Elliot got seats by the window too. I said I was being scrunched. I said I was being smushed. I said, if I don't get a seat by the window, I'm going to be carsick. No one even answered. I could tell it was going to be a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. At school, Mrs. Dickens liked Paul's picture of the sailboat better than my picture of the invisible castle. At singing time, she said I sang too loud. At counting time, she left out 16. Who needs 16? I could tell it was going to be a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. I could tell because Paul said I wasn't his best friend anymore. He said that Philip Parker was his best friend, and that Albert Moya was his next best friend, and that I was only his third best friend. I hope you sit on a tack, I said to Paul. I hope the next time you get the double-decker strawberry ice cream cone and the ice cream part falls off the cone and lands in Australia. There were two cupcakes in Philip Parker's lunch bag, and Albert got a Hershey bar with almonds, and Paul's mother gave him a piece of jelly roll that had little coconut sprinkles on the top. Guess whose mother forgot to put in dessert? It was a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. That's what it was, because after school, my mom took us all to the dentist, and Dr. Fields found a cavity in just me. Come back next week and I'll fix it, said Dr. Fields. Next week, I said, I'm going to Australia. On the way downstairs, the elevator door closed on my foot, and while we were waiting for my mom to go get the car, Anthony made me fall where it was muddy, and then when I started crying because of the mud, Nick said I was a crybaby. And while I was punching Nick for saying crybaby, my mom came back with the car and scolded me for being muddy and fighting. I'm having a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day, I told everyone. No one even answered. So when we went to the shoe store to buy some sneakers, Anthony chose white ones with blue stripes. Nick chose red ones with white stripes. I chose blue ones with red stripes. But the shoe man said, "We're all sold out." They made me buy plain old white ones, but they can't make me wear them. When we picked up my dad at his office, he said I couldn't play with his copy machine, but I forgot. He also said to watch out for the books on his desk, and I was careful as could be expected, except for my elbow. He also said don't fool around with his phone, but I think I called Australia. My dad said please don't pick him up anymore. It was a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. There were lima beans for dinner, and I hate lima beans. There was kissing on TV, and I hate kissing. My bath was too hot. I got soap in my eyes. My marble went down the drain, and I had to wear my railroad train pajamas. I hate my railroad train pajamas. When I went to bed, Nick took back the pillow he said I could keep, and the Mickey Mouse nightlight burned out, and I bit my tongue. The cat wants to sleep with Anthony, not with me. It has been a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. My mom says some days are like that. Even in Australia. Thank you for reading along with me. Hope you have a great day. But remember, even if you have a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day, some days are like that, even in Australia.
This week, a lot has been happening at our school.
In Mr. Starkey's computer programming classes, students began to learn the basics of HTML, which is the main language to build websites. And Ms. Lieberg's students learned a new workout called Pound. And finally, Ms. Waterhouse's students made out short movies of Greek myths, such as the story of Arachne from Delaney Smith.
I hope everyone of you. Anyways, she was amazing at weaving, but she had a really bad bragging problem. So then Athena, the goddess, was like, "Oh my gosh, she's so mean. You know what? I'll teach her a lesson. Everyone will see our true colors." So then she goes down and she challenges Arachne to a weaving battle.
Patriots, it's Mr. Paletta here. It is November. That is hard to believe. It's already November. It's also an election year, and that's why I'm here to do a quick little video about our expectations this week and the next couple weeks. When you come into Dunstan, I think we all have one focus, or we have one focus for all of you, and that is to leave Dunstan better than when you came in. And that's going to be both academically and just through personal growth. And we all have that same goal, and we're here to help support each other reach that goal. So I think next week's no different, the week after that's no different, and this week's no different. We need to make sure we're focused on that, and the best way to do that is be focused on in your class activities. It shouldn't be focused on what's going on in the world around. If you're in math class, we should be focused on math, language arts, or whatever class you're in. You want to be focused on that content. I do realize, though, there will be times to have conversation about what's going on outside in the world, outside of school. And so I want to kind of have those expectations. I also kind of want to talk real quickly about that we have a community who's pretty divided on the political aisle, which I think is what makes our community so strong. I think having people with different opinions, if they do it in a respectful manner, actually help each other grow. I know in my life, I have had opinions and beliefs that as I grew up, I have realized they are wrong. And I've kind of changed my opinion and beliefs. I've also had some opinion and beliefs that as I get older, they just get stronger and stronger. And I believe more today that I'm correct with them than I did, 15 years ago. And I've done this through learning people, meeting with people, and having conversation with people with different opinions. I think that's the best way to either reinforce or to reevaluate your thoughts. And so I think that's amazing that we have that opportunity here, but you need to do it in a respectful manner. So it's okay if you agree or disagree with someone. I don't really care which side of the political aisle you're on. I just want you to do it in a respectful manner so that everyone can grow. I also want us to think or realize that this week, and probably the next couple weeks, people are going to be very sensitive in this topic. Some people are going to be very happy with the outcome. Some people are going to be very disappointed in the outcome. And then the people are all in between that. And it's important to understand that's kind of where we're at this point in time. So I would recommend we stay away from these conversations. I think when emotions are high, it's harder to have those civil and respectful conversations. So that's my recommendation. But my expectation is if you have any of those conversations, you will do it in a respectful manner. And if not, then we will help you problem solve and have some conversations about what that needs to look like and how do we treat each other respectfully. So that's where we're at. If you have any questions, ask any of the adults in the building, or you can always email myself. I expect you to keep being amazing, and I'm super proud of all that you've already done this year. So let's keep up the momentum. Have a great week. Thank you.
Hello, it's Morgan Thompson here. This is sadly not a weather video, but I do have some important news about Talent for Vasco's debate team. As of now, it is only for Group B 7th graders, and it will take place Wednesdays after school in Mr. Gordon's room. Now, if you would like to join, please submit an application to this email right here, and I hope to see you there. Another quick announcement. If you have a club that's already been approved, and you have a location and everything, and you want to start it, then you can email this email, and I will make a quick announcement on it for PTV.
Hi everyone, Mr. Starkey here with a quick little yearbook announcement. Just kind of want to let you know that on the main page, there is a section now where you can get all the info on how to buy your yearbook. So all I am is just right on the main page, and you scroll down, and the recent news, if you hit read more, it then takes you to all the info you need. So you can see that it's all through your Jeffco Connect account. It's $20 through December 17th, and after that point through January, it's $22. All sales will be final. Nothing will be sold after the 18th. Okay, but just be aware of all that. Talk to your parents if you or your family want to buy a yearbook. That is where it is sold. It is on a first come first serve basis. We don't have yearbooks for everyone in the entire building, so just kind of be aware that that's how the yearbooks are sold. So for any other info, just talk to your parents. Go through this page. Go through this info, and that's about it. So with that being said, all of you rock. Keep up the good work. Bye, everybody.
That was lovely. Now is Harper with this week's weather.
Hi, this is the weather with Harper Adams. Here's a quick preview of our weather this week. On Monday, we have a high of 67 degrees, a low of 40 degrees, and we have no rain whatsoever. It'll be sunny. On Tuesday, once again, it'd be sunny. We have a high of 70 and a low of 42. A little bit warmer. Once again, no rain whatsoever. On Wednesday, we have a high of 60 and a low of 40. A little bit warmer. Once again, no chance of rain and sunny again. Got a lot of sunny days. On Thursday, we have a high of 66 and a low of 42. A little bit colder. Once again, no rain whatsoever. It'll be sunny again. On Friday, there's a change, but not that much of one. We have a high of 67 degrees, a low of 42 degrees. Zero chance of rain again, but this time it's partially cloudy. So this was the weather with Harper Adams. Have a great week.
Good job, Parker. And as always, have a wonderful week, Dunson Patriots.